Hello everyone. So in today's class, we are going to start a new chapter, which is Tales of Young Gandhi. So this is going to be a very interesting one. Almost many of you have read Gandhi's autobiography, which is My Experiment with Truth. It's written very simple, with very simple language. So even if you have not read, you can start reading it, and for the meanings and all, you will be seeing that almost these are the known words. His autobiography is the, you can say, is the most simple, written with the simplest of simplest language. So start reading. But this one is not been written by him. This is actually Jahnavi Prasad was someone who wrote this one. So just little bit of introduction I shall be giving on him. He was inspired to collect the visual content over 8 years of travel to Porbandar, London and South Africa after reading Gandhi's autobiography, The Story of My Experiment with Truth. So this is the book of Gandhi's autobiography, My Experiment with Truth. And this one, these are few excerpts, or you can say few anecdotes, you can say. So here you will be knowing, I think, about anecdotes. First, let me tell you what is an anecdote. Actually, real life situation, which is, suppose if you read the story or read the life of Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar, you will be coming to know how he helped the poor and how he touched the untouchables, or somebody who was suffering from a much kind of disease and all. Similarly, Gandhi's life, if you read, you will be coming to know about how he helped the farmer, how his childhood was, what he did in his childhood days. He was a worshipper of truth, and he in his lifetime he tried that he doesn't have to say any sort of a lie or false things. So he never have followed any unfair way. It will be seen here while we read the story that even the supervisor, the examiner, the invigilator wanted him to copy from his friends, but he could not do it himself. So these are Gandhi's life, the anecdotes, you can say. So anecdote means real life things, the things which has really taken place, which has really happened, that is called anecdote. So here we shall be starting the story, not the story, actually the account of Gandhi's life, the description of his life. So Gandhi has been called Mahatma. If you just break this word Mahatma, you will be seeing Mahan and Atma. So Mahan or Mahat means great. Atma is the soul. So great soul, he is a great soul. But as a young boy, he faced the same challenges similar to what many of us face. So though he is such a great person, but while he was a child, while he was a young boy like you all, so that time he also faced a similar kind of situation like we in our real life situation we face. Let's read an extract from the book Tales of Young Gandhi. To learn more about Gandhi as a young boy, how he was as a young boy, how his life was as a young boy. So we shall be reading those things here. On the west coast of India in Porbandar, Gujarat, lived a family, the Gandhis. Karamchand, his wife Putlibai, their daughter and three sons. So Gandhi's family had, his father was Karamchand, his mother was Putlibai, and he had one sister, and he had two brothers. He had a sister and he had two brothers. Okay, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was the youngest. He was the youngest of all. He was born on 2nd of October 1869, and as you know, 2nd October is celebrated as Gandhi Jayanti. So Gandhiji was born on 2nd of October 1869. So now he is writing, that is, as I said, few excerpts will be from the book, The Story of My Experiments with. So here we will be seeing what he is saying. I was 7 when my father moved from Porbandar to Rajkot. He joined the Rajasthani court, and court in Rajkot and enrolled me in a primary school there. So the father got the transfer. The father got transfer in his job. So the father had to take his family with him. So he got him admitted. He got little Gandhi admitted in the school in Rajkot, in a primary school. So the pictures are shown here. You can see the picture in your book. My heart wasn't in my daily lesson. I was more interested in mocking our teacher. So he was not loving the way the lesson was being imparted. His heart was not there. He was trying to mimicry, or you can say trying to imitate the teachers, how they deliver the lesson and all. I was a mediocre student. He was not a very good one, but not a very intelligent student, or also he was not a very bad student. He was in between. So mediocre student who barely got through the multiplication table, who can somehow remember the multiplication table. As you know, multiplication table. So he just barely, with much difficulty, he could remember this. My shyness led me to bury my head in the book, and even if I gasped nothing. So he just buried his head like this. He just buried his head in the book, and he, whether he understood or not, that was not a matter. He wanted to pretend that he is studying much. So that was his shyness. Out of his shyness, out of his, he was introvert kind of, he was shy kind of. So he just buried his head like this, as if he is busy in his study. That why he did, in order to hide himself, because he was ashamed, he was shy. So I disliked being taken to task at school. Now there was a custom. Now your online education, online lesson is being imparted and all. So when you had, when physically you had to come, what we did actually, we sometimes call you to the board and we ask you to write that or to solve a problem or to do a maths kind of. So what happens here? He didn't like this custom. He didn't like to be called to the board in front of everyone. He was a very shy kind of a boy, introvert kind of a boy. So he disliked, he was afraid of going to the board in front of everyone. Okay. But surely I was not a dunce. So also he is saying that I was not a dunce. I was not a very dull kind of a, very ignorant or dull kind of boy. I was not there. My luck and a wee bit of merit, W-E, W means little, very little. So my luck, the fortune that I have, everybody has a fortune, a luck. We say no luck, he is lucky, he is not unlucky. So that luck, he was a bit lucky, and also he is saying that I had little bit of merit, got me scholarships of rupees 4 and rupees 10 for 2 years. So that time you can think that in the year of 1869, that time 10 rupees or 4 rupees were not a cup of tea. Nowadays we don't, we will be seeing that these are very meager amounts, these are very less amount, very lesser amount. But that time it was a higher amount. You can think that somebody's the expense on education can be spent, can be easily paid with these kind of money, like rupees 4 or rupees 10. I took to some subjects more easily than others. So he had some sort of fondness for some subjects, and he didn't like some subjects. Initially, I found geometry challenging. So apparently, geometry was the subject which he didn't like, or you can say he found it to be challenging. That means which will put him into real challenge, which needs much concentration and devotion. But with hard work, I came to appreciate the underlying simplicity of the subject. But with much hard work, with rigorous trying, he continuously he tried to learn that, and he could appreciate, he could come to the conclusion that it had some sort of simplicity under it. Means apparently it looked very difficult, it looked very challenging, but when he tried much, when he tried to grasp, when he tried to read it, when he tried to understand it, when he tried to go deeper into the subject, he found that it was very simple. Next one, he is saying Sanskrit was harder, everything harder. Everything had to be learned by heart. Sanskrit was the language which everything has to be learned by heart. I almost switched to Persian class on hearing it was easy. So he was almost to switch into the Persian class. He thought that it was easier than Sanskrit. And the teacher was lenient, and the teacher was also not very strict. The teacher was lenient. But the Sanskrit teacher persuaded me, but the Sanskrit teacher, he called me, he persuaded me, or he tried to convince me to keep learning the language, to keep learning the Sanskrit language. So that is the teacher, the Sanskrit teacher, he persuaded him, he approached him, he convinced him that you should go for Sanskrit language. Now beside that picture, you will be seeing here, you will be seeing here, it is written run faster, it is written run faster, mana, run. So Mania is actually the nickname of him. It was the nickname of Gandhi. So Mania is actually a nickname given to Gandhi by his family. So he used to run faster because of his shyness. I was very shy. I would avoid talking to schoolmates. So when his school will be ended for the day, he will run away from the place. He will just start running from that place because he was he was introvert kind of. He didn't like to talk to his classmates and all. At the thought of being laughed at, and why he didn't, it was not like he was proud or anything like that. Rather, he did so because he was very much shy, and he thought that they will be laughing at him, they will make fun of him. It was my childhood inhibition. Inhibition here means childhood kind of fear, you can say, uncomfort, you can say, discomfort, you can say. So it was in his childhood, he didn't like to do this. So it was kind of a discomfort. It was a thing which put him into much uneasiness. So he had inhibition, you can say, uneasiness, discomfort. Okay, in his childhood, he felt uneasy to talk to his friend, to talk to his classmates and schoolmates, because he thought that they will be making fun of him, they can laugh at him and all. Okay. Next one, in high school, my headmaster, Dorabji Edulji Jimmy, Dorabji Edulji Jimmy, was he made gymnastics, football and cricket compulsory for all of us. So the high school when he, it was earlier in the, up to this phase we have read what he did in the school, why he was in the primary school. Now when he came to the high school, the headmaster, Jimmy was the name of the headmaster, he made the gymnastics, the football and cricket, everything compulsory. I sarked from them. I was afraid, I just turned away from them. It was my shyness once again that haunted me on the playground as well. It was my shyness, as I was shy, I was introvert kind of, so this was dragging me from behind. This shyness of mine was dragging me from behind that I will not play. If I go to playground, if people laugh at me, if they make fun of me, so I will better, I will be running away, I will turn away from that place. Later, as you know, Gandhiji was the one who afterwards who told in education there is a theory called holistic theory, H-O-L-I-S-T-I-C. Holistic theory means all-round development of a student, all-round development of a child. So here, the student's moral, cultural and also physical, that means the sports, his study, his behavioral things, everything comes under the everything comes under one territory. This is called holistic development, and Gandhiji was a you can say he was actually, he wanted this holistic development in the child. He wanted that our school system, our nation India should always be striving for this holistic development and all. So he is saying here that later I came to realize that physical training is as important as mental training. So we, the teacher, always encourages that you study, you read this poem, you learn this poem, you read this story. But also this physical fitness, that is means the sports and games and all these are also equally very important. So here Gandhiji is saying, later I came to realize that physical training is as important as mental training. I read the regular long walks in the open air were good for health, so I formed a habit of it, which kept me fit and robust. So he started to walk in the fresh morning air, which kept him fit and robust. One day I wanted to skip gymnastics and rush home to attend my ill father. Now, as you know, he was a great lover of his, he was very much devoted, he was very much respectful, very much obedient, a child towards his father. Sometimes it is said that he writes in his autobiography that he used to run away from, as soon as the school ended, he didn't spend any moment, any minute, rather than he will be running back to his home to serve his father, to take care of his father. His father was ill, so he wanted to take care of his father. So he will not, he wanted to not attend the gymnastics. He wanted to go home early to serve his ailing father, to serve his father who was ill, to take care of him. My earnest request to leave school early was not accepted by Mr. Jimmy. The headmaster didn't accept the proposal. The headmaster was, he wrote to the headmaster an application or a letter that I want to skip the gymnastics class today because I have to go to my home to attend my ill father. But the headmaster turned down the proposal. The headmaster didn't accept it, didn't grant it. The following Saturday, there was a compulsory gymnastics class at 4 o'clock. I had no watch and I miscalculated the hour. So the next Saturday he had another gymnastics class at 4 o'clock, and he had, as he had no watch, so he at that time, as you know, no mobile phone was there, so he could not know about the time. By the time I reached school, all the boys had left. By the time he reached school, everybody had left. Oh no, just my luck. So he is saying that it is his luck. The next day, the headmaster is saying, Mahandas, stop lying about your absence. So the headmaster is rebuking, he is very much angry. Then nothing doing. I refuse to believe you. Just pay off your fine of 1 or 2 annas and be done with it. So for not attending this one, that was his punishment, that he will have to pay the fine. Despite my other flaws, I never ever lied to my teacher. I failed to prove my innocence. So that was the greatest quality of this man. He never ever lied. He never lied to his teacher. So this is what moral lesson the chapter will convey to you, that one should not lie. And these are the situations where if you lie, it actually is a moral degradation. So here Gandhiji is saying us that I have never lied to my teacher. I failed to prove my innocence, but at the same time I failed to prove my innocence that I have not done anything, I'm not telling you wrong. Really the father was ill and I had to attend him, or I didn't have the watch, that is why I couldn't reach the class on time. So all these he could not make him believe, but at the same time in the core of his heart he knew that he was not lying it to the teacher, he was not lying. To me the act of cheating was awful. Gandhi ji is saying, to me, the act of cheating was awful. For the high school examination, we had to write 5 words as spelling exercise. All the other boys spelled every word correctly. As Mr. Giles, the supervisor encouraged cheating. The supervisor, the invigilator, he told that you can copy it down from your friend, from your classmate. But he, Gandhiji, this very act of lying, the very act of cheating, he didn't like. I couldn't spell kettle. And in fact, I spelled every word wrong. I refused to be prompted. And prompted here means that somebody is telling you from the behind, somebody is telling the answer from the behind in the whispering tone, somebody is telling the answer from the behind, that is called prompting. So I also didn't like this. I also refused to listen to those promptings and all. Because, okay, I have done mistake, I have written all the spelling, 5 spelling I have committed wrong, let it be. It's fine with me. But the very unfair means, following the unfair means to pass the exam, it was not in his nature. I still had deep respect for Mr. Giles, as I did for all my teachers and elders. And another great thing that Gandhiji had, though the teacher had some negative attributes, though the teacher inspired something which is unfair, which he should not do, which was against his virtue as a teacher, the teacher should not never ever encourage a student to cheat. The teacher should never ever encourage a student that you copy down from your friend in the exam. So it was, though it was against the nature of a teacher, against what a teacher should not behave in this way, but still he had great respect for Mr. Giles as he had for all other teachers. Isn't he there to prevent us from copying? So that was actually in his mind, the line was coming, that he is there to prevent us from copying, but actually what he was doing, he was just doing the opposite thing. So in our next class, we shall be doing the question answers from this chapter. You all read this chapter. This is a very interesting one. Also, if possible, you can read some whenever you will be getting some leisure time. You can also read My Experiment with Truth by Gandhiji. Thank you. Have a nice day. Thank you once again.